lost his mother, we thought, how can he understand that he won't see his mother? How can he understand that she's dead? And after the funeral, the assistant who was sleeping downstairs, they would go and see him. And usually he cries and yells really loud. But those nights we didn't hear him. And one assistant one night walked in and saw the tears.
There are many, many moments throughout the day that we are really in communion. Yeah, in moments that you feel close to a certain person, you can really say, yeah, he understood, or she understood. You have to spend time and take time to really discover this.
Hard to kind of live with yourself, let alone with other people. And I think the handicapped people become a very great challenge in the way they live, in their kind of capacity to live very fully in the present moment and to celebrate and to rejoice. And there's a real honesty about them. They live very much straightforwardly, you know, from the heart. For me, you know, I've kind of got layers of intellectualization there, and so there's a kind of stripping away that seems to be happening, and it's painful.
The altar is on a big stone which comes from a quarry not too far from here. And they didn't want that stone. There was some malformation in the stone, so the builders didn't want it. And because they didn't want it, it was given to us. And of course it's a sign of a word of the Psalms, which was taken again by Jesus and said by Peter, in the letter of Peter, that the stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. And this is Jesus, because Jesus was rejected. They didn't want Jesus, because Jesus calls for universal love. He calls for the breaking down of barriers between people. He calls for peace and forgiveness. And of course, it's our people as well. We believe that our people, people with disabilities, they are also that stone that has been rejected, that nobody wants, put in institutions, hidden away, killed before birth. And yet they, I believe, are the cornerstone where humanity can be rebuilt. We are a mixture of light and darkness, and we're a mixture of strength and weakness. And if we just play on our strengths, well, then either we're going to kill people or we're going to be killed. But somewhere, if we can welcome our weakness, then we become whole. Today the strong are strong, but yesterday they were weak, they were little children. And tomorrow they'll be weak, they'll have Alzheimer's, or they'll be sick, or they'll have cancer. Because this is what society is about. It's people being born, people being strong, people dying. People who have succeeded, people who have failed. And a human society is when all these can live together in mutual recognition. And that means that we have to accept our weakness. And there is where you find somebody like Bonhoeffer saying, a society can only be a society not just where the weak need the strong, but the strong need the weak. I mean, we need to be together, because then I'll be able to accept myself as I am.